Hello everybody, it's Iman from Tinkering with Tech, and today we're going to review the Q7 smartwatch from Hello. This is the smartwatch itself. Now, it resembles the Apple Watch very much, and it has like a very, like a bit advanced functionalities than the Apple Watch. We shall get to it in a minute. Now, from the Apple side, it's a very good looking smartwatch. I've been using it for the last 3 months, and it's very beautiful. It's a bit rigid, but it's not waterproof or anything, so if you want to wash your hand, you need to take it off and then wash your hand, which is a bit negative. Then the Apple Watch, the original one, it supports like wireless charging, but this one does not support wireless charging. You need to charge it via a micro USB charger, and if you open the tab right here, then it can charge. The tab becomes a bit loose after like frequent use, or like, you know, everyday use of it. Then the knob here, if you press it, then the home menu comes up. If you press it again, it closes. Then when the clock comes up, you have to pull it up like this, and this is the home menu. And if you pull it up again, this is like the main, all the features here, the music, the video, or yeah, here. Then if you like, you know, come back to the home screen, if you press it again here, I'll show you. This is the like main menu. If you press it again, it will come back to the home screen. Now when it comes back to the home screen, there are like two options. You can like call somebody, or like text somebody, or like receive messages. Then if you pull down the slot here, then this is like the managing window on which all mobile phones have. Here you can control like this is the Bluetooth one, and this is like the vibration or like silent mode, the airplane mode, and the brightness. Now the brightness is a bit tricky. I currently use it on the lowest brightness, and I did not have a problem till like, you know, extreme sunny days or something like that. Now on the lowest brightness, the battery, the battery is 400 mAh battery. It lasts for like 2 days minus a night, which is a bit weird, but let me explain. If you like take off the charging in the morning, use it the whole day, turn it off, and use it the next day also, you can last for 2 whole days on the lowest setting. But if you use it, like if you crank up the brightness to the max, you may get like 1 day or like 1 day or 1.5 days of use from it, which is a negative, I know, but what can you blame? It's a really small form factor. You need the smallest size of battery because you need to fit everything else in. Now the touch display, the touch is a bit off. Like if you press in the center, it's perfect, but if you go here, it's a bit, if you like, let me explain. This is the screen. If you press here, it will be registered here, a bit like half a millimeter of difference, which may not sound like much, but if you see the QWERTY option on the keyboard and you want to type, you will face some major pain, because you will type this key and that key will open and you need to erase it, and which is another pain. But if you use it like on the number pad system, 1 ABC ADEF, that function, it's great. If you, because then the keys are big enough for no touch interference, which is great. Okay, then moving on, like the dial, the problem with the dial is that it only acts as a switch. There is no like dial action when you spin it and the menu moves. It doesn't work on it, so which is a negative. Then it supports an independent SIM card and the SD card slot, which is a major positive, because then you can use it like a independent mobile, and you can make like calls from it and receive text messages on it. You don't need another mobile to like back it up and like use it with the mobile, but you have a Bluetooth option. Now the cool feature is that as it supports the SD card slot, you can fill like songs on the SD card, and then you can play music on a Bluetooth speaker, and then, you know, you can play music on the go, which is a major plus. Then the SIM size is a bit odd. For a form factor like this, you will always want to like cram things in at the smallest size possible. But the manufacturer decided to use like the nano SIM, which is like in the middle of the micro and the standard size. Because I would always recommend like to go for the smallest size to save space there and like add something else, like increase the battery size a bit. Who knows? You could do that if it was a nano SIM and there was no SD card slot. But they decided to, if it was a micro SIM, but they decided to put a nano SIM, which is okay. But I mean, you can like increase the size or decrease the size, but you know, they could save a bit of a space there. Now it also has a camera, which is like you know, expected on smartwatches. Now the camera is great for taking selfies, and if you wanna like, it's if the lighting is okay, then the camera is absolutely great. I would rate it like a 7 out of 10 for, you know, on the good lighting condition. But if the lighting is not good, I would not even give it a 2 for, like, you know, in the category of like smartphone cameras. It's really bad on the low light conditions. So yeah, you might want to consider that. Now let's get on, should you buy it or not? This one I bought it from China. When I visited China, I bought it from there. It cost me like $30 or so. From there, it may be a bit more for you if you're like, if you live somewhere else. But even though I said like many negatives, oh, and another negative, I know, like, hold on a bit, it's not waterproof. Yeah, but it's a cheap watch, who can you blame for that? Like, I know I mentioned a lot of negatives, but when you use it for a bit, you'll get the hang of it and you'll really enjoy it. I've been enjoying it myself. If I didn't enjoy it, I honestly would have thrown it away, because it's a cheap watch. Nobody would bother like keeping it if it was a major pain to use it. So yeah, I would recommend buying it if the price is, you know, like a bit different than $30 in your space, but it's a great buy for the price and the functionality, and it's a good looking watch. It looks like the Apple Watch. Yeah, so thank you for watching the video. If you liked it, then please leave a like. If you're new to the channel, then please consider subscribing, and I'll see you next time.